School administrators, teachers and parents have been warned against aiding bribery in schools by giving children sweets and money to distribute to other students to vote for them during prefect campaigns. Educations worry the habit is a breeding ground for cultural corruption.
Teachers, but I'm afraid to observe that right from the national level, elections have been monetized, which we blame by shouldn't get a hold of the day. And as the Chikanda saying goes, that union isn't of Uruka, so we should desist from that system. We should instill discipline in our kids. This should be handled by the teachers and the parents together. It shouldn't be a one-sided, but as parents, we need to instill ethics and blame this habit of bribing, because it's the order that does it now.
Currently, voter bribery is one of the vote malpractices which is discouraged by the Electoral Commission at the national level.
I have to thank my parents for listening to us. At the beginning, when we started these campaigns, parents were coming in with the packets of sweets, packets of biscuits, boxes of biscuits, and this to give their children, to those who are standing, to bribe others and give them votes. We discouraged this from the word go. We talked to our parents and we asked them not to go on with such a habit, because if that habit continues, it's going to crop up even when they grow up at the national level. If you bribe at a primary level and a child goes up to the national level, that means whatever he will be doing, he will be bribing.
The matter arose during the swearing-in of 43 prefects of Kwagalakwe Primary School in Goma Division, Mukono Municipality.
It is leading by example. It is not a title. If you are a prefect in charge of dormitory, you should not be found doing other things in class because your title stops in the dormitory. If you are a prefect in charge of meals, you should not wait for the dining. And when the one in charge of classes or the class monitor is writing down your papers, you're the list. Number one in the list. That means in everything you do from today onwards, you're the eyes of the administration, you're the eyes of the rest of the school. What you do will emulate. What you do will affect you.
Sister Florence Nalumo, the head teacher of St. Teresa Girls Boarding Primary School, says as a school built on the foundation, they encourage children to desist from such cases of malpractice.
As we train these girls, this young generation, we encourage them to be faithful, to do things rightly, not bribe. Better do the good work, then the voters, whoever sees, will see and then vote. For us, we have here elections, and we prepare for elections in our schools. We discourage such. Though they look at the elder and they are doing it, but for us, we tell them do things rightly, faithfully, and God will reward you. If you deserve a post, you will get it.
Report by Henry Nsubuga for the news.